welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallis. In this video, we'll look at how we can fork and source our shell scripts. So we're sat comfortably on the command line of my Raspberry Pi, and we're running the bash shell here. We're going to start off by looking at the $$ variable, which will represent the process ID of the currently running process. Well, of course, then that's going to be my bash shell. So my bash shell is currently running with the process ID of 8733. Remember that number. This becomes important to us because we can use this within the script and work out which bash shell something is running in. So if I go through and we'll create a new and simple script for the moment. So if I just go through and vi, and we'll just put through to my home directory and then bin, and we'll just call it process.sh. And hit the insert key. We know we're going to have the shebang as our starting point, and that's then going to be /bin/bash on this system. And then we're going to use that same statement that we saw, so echo $$, echo out the process ID. And of course, then we need to go through and make this executable, so chmod plus x. And we can specify a little bit of a shortcut here. We can just use the last argument, so !$. And then, as we see, it's expanded through then into $home/bin/process. So now let's go through and execute the script. It's in my path statement, so I can run it straight like this. So we can see then that the process.sh script is running in a separate or forked back bash process. All we mean by forked is that whilst that script is running, we have to wait until we can type again at the command prompt of my original bash shell. So I started off from process ID 8733. We then forked a new bash process that was 8749. That ran and then returned control back to bash at process ID 8733. And of course, that's the normal way that we would expect. But the variables that are used in the fork shell are completely isolated and just for that shell. So of course, when I look at echo $$ back, we're still looking at my current shell 8733, not what the process script was running. Now, this becomes important to us because if we go back and look at editing that script again, so I can just run history and vi, and we're going to change this slightly. We'll start using some variables. If I go through and specify, we'll just have something like username. We'll have that set to the value of Fred. And then we're going to echo out then the value of the username variable. So when we're setting the variable, we don't use the dollar, but when we're reading a variable, we use the dollar. So we're populating the username variable with the value of Fred. With that set, if I look at the moment, echo $username, tab completing here, it doesn't exist, but I can try and echo it out, we have no value. And if I run the script again, so again, I just use !P to go back through my history, we can see then that it's running and I'm seeing the result or the value of the Fred, or the value Fred from the username variable. But if I go through and look for that username variable, it's not in this shell. It existed for a very short amount of time, just whilst the script was running, and it's already been destroyed when the script exited. Should we need to keep it, and perhaps if we were trying to debug it, we might want to check some variable names interactively from the command line. If I go through and source the script. And again, we'll keep it easy. I just use exclamation mark S. So again, we source then the home bin process. So we see the same result. But now when I go back and look at the echo command from my shell, when I echo out $username, you can see now that I actually have the variable within my shell. So of course, we have to be careful about this. We don't want to destroy the environment that we're in. We're typically going to use this source, though, when we do want to set the environment. So if I go through and source bash.bashrc, I read then my login script into my current environment. So hopefully this has given you a little bit of an idea about the difference between sourcing a script, running it in the current environment, or running the script in the normal manner, or forking the script so it runs in its own separate environment. Thank you very much for looking, and I look forward to seeing you back on theurbanpenguin.com very soon.